Can you solve this geometry challenge? Here's the question. Given this right triangle with the side length x squared, x cubed, and x raised to the fourth power, and our goal is to solve for the value of x. Now, you can pause this video if you want to give this problem a try. And now, let's answer this question together. Alright, so given this right triangle with the side length x squared, x cubed, and x raised to the fourth power, our goal is to solve for the value of x. Of course, the real value of x. So x must be a real number. Alright, so to answer this question, we will use one theorem. Of course, since we have a right triangle, so we will use the Pythagorean theorem. So, Pythagorean theorem, we have a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Now, a and b are the legs of this right triangle and c is the hypotenuse of this right triangle. So, applying this Pythagorean theorem to our right triangle, we have something like x squared raised to the power of 2 plus x cubed raised to the power of 2 equals x raised to the fourth power or the hypotenuse raised to the power of 2. Now, let's simplify this. X squared raised to the power of 2, this can be simplified as x raised to the fourth power. Next, x raised to 3 raised to the power of 2, this can be written as x raised to the power of 3 times 2 or simply equal to x raised to the power of 6. And for the last one, x raised to the fourth power raised to the power of 2, this can be simplified to x raised to the power of 8. Now, from here, take note that x cannot be equal to 0 because if x equals to 0, all of the side of this right triangle must be equal to 0 and we don't want to have that 1. So we can say that x is not equal to 0. So why is this important? Because what we're going to do is to divide all of these terms by x raised to the fourth power. Because we know x is not equal to 0, x raised to the fourth power is not equal to 0. Alright, now let's simplify. X raised to the fourth power over x raised to the fourth power, this will give us 1. Next, x raised to the sixth power over x raised to the fourth power, this will give us x raised to the power of 2 or simply x squared. Lastly, x raised to the power of 8 over x raised to the fourth power, this will give us x raised to the power of 4. Now, let's rearrange some terms a little bit and let's equate this to 0. So we have 0 equals x raised to the fourth power minus x squared minus 1. Now also take note that x raised to the fourth power, this can be written as x raised to the power of 2 raised to the power of 2. Now why we do that? Because notice we have here x squared and we have here also x squared. So to make this equation simple, let's replace x squared with another variable and let's call this as t. Now, since x squared is t, so we can replace all x squared as the variable t. So it looks something like this. So we have 0 equals t squared minus t minus 1. So this is now a quadratic equation. Now, to solve for the value of t, we will use the quadratic formula. So we have t equals negative b plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. So this is the famous quadratic formula. Now, a here in the formula must be the coefficient of t squared and that is equivalent to 1. Now, this b is the coefficient of t which is negative 1. And c is the constant term which is also negative 1. Now, let's replace all of their values to our formula. Now, let's replace all a with 1. This will give us negative b plus or minus b squared minus 4c all over 2. Next, all b replace with negative 1. And all c replace by negative 1. Next, let's simplify. Negative 1 squared is 1. Negative 4 times negative 1, this is positive 4. So the number inside the radical sign must be equal to 1 plus 4 or simply equal to 5. Next, negative of negative 1, this is just positive 1. So we get that the value of t must be equal to 1 plus or minus square root of 5 all over 2. But take note, t is equal to x squared, and we know x squared must be greater than or equal to 0. So this number or t cannot be a negative number. Therefore, we need to disregard this negative value of t, which is 1 minus square root of 5 over 2. Therefore, we can say that t must be equal to 1 plus square root of 5 over 2. Or simply, this is the famous the golden ratio, of course. Now, let's focus on the value of t. We have 1 plus square root of 5 over 2. And we also know that t must be equal to x squared. So, we can replace this t as x squared because we want here is the value of x. Now, x squared must be equal to 1 plus square root of 5 over 2. To solve for the value of x, let's get the square root on both sides. And then, take note that we have an even exponent. So, we have two possible values here. We have positive or negative. Now, the left-hand side of our equation, this is just x. Now, we have two possible values for x here. We have positive square root of 1 plus square root of 5 over 2 or negative square root of 1 plus square root of 5 all over 2. But take note, we have here x cubed. So, if x is a negative number, so let's say, for example, negative square root of 1 plus square root of 5 all over 2, and we raise it to the third power like this, so we get something like x cubed must be a negative number because negative times negative times negative must be a negative number. So we don't want to have a negative side length of this triangle. Therefore, we can disregard the negative value of x. So this will leave us the only value of x given this right triangle must be equal to square root of 1 plus square root of 5 over 2, or also known this 1 plus square root of 5 over 2, also known as phi or the golden ratio. So x must be equal to square root of the golden ratio. And that is our answer to this question. And as always, we are done.